Hello students, in this part we are going to learn about the energy density of an EM waves. So as we have already know that whenever the EM waves travel in the space, they will possess the energy. And what energy they possess? They share the energy in an electrical energy and a magnetic field or an electric field. So that is called its energy density. What is energy density? Energy density is defined as the energy in unit volume of the space through which the waves travel is called its energy density. So we know then in free space, we know that in free space the energy density of static field, this we have already calculated in the previous, okay? So that will be UE is equals to half of epsilon naught E square, okay? And again, if we need to find out the energy density in free space for the magnetic field, so we found that is, this is also for the case of the static magnetic field. This we have calculated in unit 2 and this we have calculated in unit 3. So UB is equals to 1 upon 2 mu naught B square. But we know that when it is moving, it means it will be producing electric and magnetic field and both has to be accelerating. It means something which is in motion. So we can say the total energy density of the static electric and magnetic field, what will be total? It will be U is equals to UE plus of UB, which is half of epsilon naught E square plus of half of mu naught B square. This will be the energy density. But if we talk about electromagnetic waves, they possess both electric and magnetic field, which are sinusoidally, or we can say which is accelerating or which will be changing with respect to time. So the average velocity, sorry, for the average density, what we have to do is we need to replace this E and B with their, we need to replace static electric and magnetic field with their RMS value. We have to replace with RMS value. Why we have to replace with RMS value? That will give us its sinusoidal value. So that will be E is equals to E square RMS plus of half mu naught B RMS. That will show its moving or sinusoidal value. So if we are taking our ERMS, so I know that I can substitute ERMS is equals to E naught upon root 2. Similarly, I can substitute BRMS is equals to magnitude of B naught upon root of 2. So in place of this, I have this RMS value. What I can find out? I can substitute here the value. So I can also write this as 1 upon 4 epsilon naught E naught square plus of 1 upon 4 mu naught B naught ka square. This value I can substitute. Now what I have to do? Now this was the expression which we have obtained. So we already know that is E naught is equals to C B naught. From the properties also we have discussed that this expression we already know. That is basically I have written E naught upon B naught is equals to C. And what is the value of this we have? That is C square is equals to under root. We write it down like this. The theory of relativity, C square is equals to mu naught. So here my total UE will turns to 1 upon 4 epsilon naught E naught square, which will be 1 upon 4 pi 1 upon 4 epsilon naught C B naught whole square. From here I can substitute this C B naught whole square. I can substitute this value because I want to change one in the form of another. So this is the value which we have for E naught. We have substituted. So we have this equation as 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught B naught square upon mu naught epsilon naught, which will be equals to 1 upon 4 mu naught B naught whole square is equals to UB. Okay, so hence the electromagnetic waves are the average energy of the electric field. So this is the expression which we have obtained for the energy density in this case. So I hope this is clear to you. So this is all about energy density. Now the intensity of EM waves. What is the intensity of EM waves? Intensity of EM waves is defined as I is equals to energy. Here it is written, that is unit area per unit time in a direction perpendicular to the direction of propagation is called the intensity of the wave. Means how much waves are passing in a given area in a unit time is called its intensity of the wave. So that is area into time. So we know what is the energy, that is represented by U, capital U, A into del of T, which will be equals to U into C. Because if you will see here, what is that AU, small u into C del T, that is the average unit energy density. So we have I is equals to half of epsilon naught E square C, which will be equals to epsilon naught E square RMS into C. So this will be your equation for the intensity in a electric field. That will be for the magnetic field, you can find it out in the same manner, because EM wave consists both. So the same formula we can have in this way, that will be B square RMS into C. Now the momentum of the EM wave. So what is the momentum of the EM waves? You can write, of EM waves. What is the momentum of the EM waves? P is equals to U upon C. Okay, this is the momentum of the EM waves, where energy or C will be the velocity, the speed of light. So this will be what expression which you have to keep it in mind in this chapter. Only this much you have to study. So with this, we have completed this chapter. Thank you. Now we are going to discuss some numericals. The first numerical says, the amplitude of the oscillating magnetic field in an electromagnetic wave is given. We have, that is an amplitude of magnetic field, that is B naught, they have given to us, that is 2 into 10 to the power minus 6 Tesla. What will be the amplitude of the oscillating electric field? We need to find out the amplitude of an oscillating electric field. So we know that EM wave possess what? Magnetic field and electric field both. So we have the relation E naught is equals to C B naught. We need to find out the value of the magnitude of E naught. So how we can find out? So we can find out easily, because we know what is that C value, 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, that is the speed of light. So here we have E naught is equals to 3 into 10 to the power 8 into 2 into 10 to the power minus 6. So this will comes out to be 600 volt per meter. This will be your electric field. So this is the answer for your electric field. So now we are going to see the second problem. Now the problem 2 says, in a plane electromagnetic wave, the electric field oscillates sinusoidally with a frequency of 2 into 10 to the power 10 hertz. The amplitude is 48 volt per meter. What is the wavelength of an EM wave? Calculate the amplitude of the oscillating magnetic field. Calculate the average energy density of the electromagnetic field of the wave. So here if you will see what is given in the question, they have given us the frequency. From the given unit, you need to understand what they have given. So they have given us the frequency of an electromagnetic wave, that is 2 into 10 to the power 10 hertz. Along with that, they have given us the amplitude in voltmeter. It means they have given us the amplitude of an electric field, that is 48 volt per meter. After that, we need to calculate the first part. They are asking us to calculate the wavelength of an EM wave. We need to calculate the wavelength of an EM wave. So if you will see, we have the formula, that is C is equals to mu into lambda, because this is the formula which we are using, the velocity, frequency and the wavelength. So this formula we can use, lambda is equals to, we have c upon wavelength. So what is that c? 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, and wavelength already given 10 to the power 10. So obviously we have the wavelength lambda is equals to 1.5 into 10 to the power minus 2 meters. So this will be the wavelength. See, these are the formulas which you have to keep it in mind. Second thing, we have to calculate the amplitude of an oscillating magnetic field. So again, which formula we are going to use? Magnetic field ka pata karna hai, electric field ka diya hai. So we have the formula C is equals to B naught. So B naught will be what? It will be E naught upon C. What is that E naught? 48 upon 3 into 10 to the power 8. So this will comes out to be 16 into 10 to the power minus 8 Tesla. This will be the answer for this. Now the third thing, we need to calculate the average density. How we can calculate the average density for this? Half of epsilon naught E naught square. We have the value of everything. We can substitute here. Half epsilon naught ki value 8.85 into 10 to the power minus 12 into E naught square 48 into 48. After solving, we will get 10 to the power minus 8 joule per meter cube. This will be the answer for the energy density. So this way we have to do all such problems. So I hope this is clear to you. Now we are going to see its next problem.